Hi friends, good to have a little bit of time with you once again. Hope you are doing well in the Lord's grace as we continue on with the shelter in place process that we're in. Hopefully these things will begin to lift before too long. We're certainly praying that way and eager to be able to join together again in gathering on Sunday mornings and at other times. But I trust you're knowing the Lord's grace in the midst of everything. I want to just point your attention to a passage in Scripture to share a few thoughts again. Some things have been on my heart and mind as I've been thinking of you and praying for you. This is in Philippians chapter 1, encouragement from Paul's example. Listen to what he says in verses 12 to 14 in Philippians 1. He says, I want you to know, brothers, that what has happened to me has really served to advance the gospel, so that it has become known throughout the whole imperial guard and to all the rest that my imprisonment is for Christ. And most of the brothers, having become confident in the Lord by my imprisonment, are much more bold to speak the word without fear. And what's significant with Paul's example is that even in the adverse circumstances of his imprisonment, what's preeminent in his heart and his mind is how God is using his circumstances for the advancement of the gospel. And I think for all of us, that is an example and an encouragement that we continually need to lay hold of, that whatever circumstances God's ordained for us, that we would be alert to and responsive to the opportunities that God brings within those circumstances for the advancement of the gospel. And for all of us, as this process wears on with COVID-19 and with our stay-at-home directives, it gets tiring and it gets wearying and it can get very monotonous, can get very discouraging. But I just want to encourage you, even in the midst of it, to be praying about, to be thinking about, how is God using these things in my own circumstances right now for the advancement of the gospel, for the opportunities to speak of Christ to those who don't know him, and to be encouraging those who do know him in Christ. It's interesting, throughout Paul's letter to the Philippians, again and again, he reflects upon his own joy in the hope of the gospel. And it's clear that he loves Christ and that he treasures Christ and that he's delighting in Christ and trusting Christ and that he's confident in Christ and that he's content in Christ. All of those themes are interwoven in all that he has to say throughout the book of Philippians, and it's in that very context that he's overflowing with eagerness to see the purposes of Christ in the hope of the gospel continually advanced. And so rather than grumbling, rather than complaining, rather than just being discouraged, he's seen all of his circumstances, even being in prison, in the perspective of how God is using them to advance the gospel. And so just want to encourage you that way, as I do in my own soul, that we keep the main thing the main thing and be looking for and being responsive to those opportunities in the gospel. I don't know how it plays out for you, but even in our own neighborhood, as Lori and I have been taking a lot of walks and we've been having more opportunity to get to know and interact with other neighbors, those somewhat natural and very common opportunities have become opportunities to interact about Christ and to interact about the gospel, sometimes in greater degrees, sometimes in lesser degrees, but just even being out in our neighborhood here and there and having those opportunities becomes an occasion to see the advance of the gospel. And we're continually praying for those kinds of opportunities, as I just want to encourage you to be doing as well, as I know so many of you are. But take heart, brothers and sisters. God is at work in these circumstances. He has his purposes, and his will for us in whatever circumstances he's ordained is continually to be about the advancement of the gospel, even as we're trusting, rejoicing in, and being content and confident in Christ and in the things that he's ordained. So just want to encourage you that way and let you know that I'm praying for you in those ways. As always, just want to mention a few things by way of some updates and some encouragements for you. We are hoping and we're praying to be able to resume our gatherings as soon as possible. There's not an immediate time frame on that yet. As many of you know, the current county guidelines that we've been given are to run through May 1st, which is a week from this coming Friday. And at that point, I'm sure they'll give some updates. And of course, we're hoping and praying that they'll be lifting some of the restrictions. Exactly what that's going to mean and what that's going to look like for our gatherings, we don't know yet. But we're working toward assembling a small team of people that can help just deal with those things as we get reoriented and as we kind of re-enter the anticipation of gathering together at River City. So be praying with us about all of that. We want to meet together as soon as we can and do so in appropriate ways. And so we'll certainly keep you posted on that, and hopefully that will be something that will come sooner rather than later. I want to let you know that Tim Ingram is going to be preaching this coming Sunday from God's Word back in the Gospel of Matthew or Gospel of Mark. So be praying for Tim as he'll be preaching. He's also going to be leading our equipping hour on this Sunday at 5 o'clock on Zoom. And so pray for Tim as he prepares for all of that and as we continue in the formats that we've been doing for a number of weeks. Some of you have been asking about our son Tyler. Many of you know that he was diagnosed recently with viral meningitis, and in God's grace, he's doing much better. He's continued to be improving this week, and so we're very thankful for that. Thankful for those of you who have been praying for he and for Katie as they've been moving through that. And even as I'm recording this on Wednesday morning, the 22nd, as most of you know, Smokey Nevins is scheduled to go into surgery this morning. And so continue to be praying for him and for Patty and for their children and grandchildren. As he goes through this process, we're trusting the Lord's care and the Lord's provision in every way, and appreciate your prayers in all of that. And encourage you to continue to be praying for one another, as I know that you are, and looking for those opportunities to minister to and encourage one another, even as you're also seeking to continue to advance the gospel. So thanks for tuning into this. As always, myself and the other elders, pastor elders, have you in our prayers. We love you very much. We are eager to be back together again, and trust God's richest blessings to you in Christ. Thanks so much. And God bless. Bye-bye.